1, 2, 3. All right, hello everybody. My name is Ash, and I'm gonna bring you guys some Fallout 3. Now, frustratingly, after many downloads, many fixed attempts, many hours looking online, can't get this fucking game to run on PC. It just crashes at the logo. Torrenting it doesn't work. Playing it, installing Windows games for Windows Live. Data doesn't work, and basically every method that I've read has failed to work. So I'm just gonna say it's my computer that doesn't want to run it, which is frustrating because I've been wanting to replay this game. So we've had to make a massive compromise. We're playing on the Xbox 360 version, which is great, and I don't even think I have the DLCs. On this version. I thought like downloading this backwards compatible version on the Xbox One would give us the DLC, but apparently not, so we'll see what happens. Not that I'm too fussed about the DLC. I mean, I would have liked to do Point Lookout, but I'm not too arsed.
But one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as Vault. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky. The giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
I need to check between my legs and have a good look.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Let's keep it nice and simple.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
All right. Give him a big fat headed piece of shite. Now I'll make him skinny. You know, I don't really care for this stuff. Pet style. Ooh, bloody hell. See what we got out here. Punk, ugh, no. Think I might go with Warhawk. Yeah, Warhawk. Hair color. Yeah, let's go with... Oh god, let's go with pure red. Yeah, we'll go with the chopper. I'll do it. Yeah, fuck it, we'll go with chopper. We'll say done.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Dad's white at the moment. He'll get a race change in a second, don't worry about him.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
You one minute. We need a doctor, not a dead man.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations, and there will be no
repercussions. James and his cheery chatter.
Straight into the light, alternating boys in this place will feel just like home. You get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy. You can do it. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
I can already tell this is going to be fun. The controls are clunky, and the frame rate looks like crap, but at least the game is functioning. There's more that I can say for the PC version. The fucking game. You can't just download and play it. You have to fucking run mods and shit. It's so stupid. I think this is too... God, it's so clunky. I went from... I don't think even those 2 points made a difference. Anyway, let's start building our character. Okay, so we want 6 strength, 6 perception. I think because the DLC isn't there, we might end up fucking ourselves over a little bit with this, but whatever. Charisma, I don't really care for. Intelligence, 9, because intelligence bobblehead, y'all. Agility 6 and luck 9. There we are. That'll do me good. So I'm since the controls kind of suck ass in this. I'm gonna try and lean on VATS to do most of the work. VATS and crits. So that's why we got luck. Of course, the perception and the agility isn't the highest. I did give myself purely for carry weight. Quite the little explorer, aren't you? Maybe I should have got away with a... Maybe, you know what, maybe I might drop that to 5 strength.
It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Because I don't have access to Strongback, because I was planning on getting a perk called... what's it called? Almost Perfect? Or No Weaknesses? Or something like that. Yeah, no weaknesses, and I don't have access to that. So, yeah, might have to drop strength down by a point and bump up maybe perception. Just for some VATS accuracy.
We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her. I miss her.
Surprise! Sandy, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What are you two?
What's that carry weight at then? 210, yeah, we can manage that. Hey, Wally.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You didn't feel... Oh, wow. Dude, I have to lie about my own... whatever. Great party, Amata. Thanks for doing this for me.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
A date with Christine Kendall?
Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than me and Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
I think Paul's gone soft on us.
Alright, so that, what we just got, is a skill book, but we won't be reading that. Not yet.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Happy birthday, dork face.
Happy birthday.
Attention, everyone. It's time to cut the cake.
Enjoying yourself?
Look at me, like a angry little shit at the moment. Look at that fucking piss and vinegar look that I've got. I think I found a thumbnail for this first part.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
Oh, you didn't have to bring me a present, Mrs. Palmer.
Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Get it?
Are you having
Who
a
wants
nice
to go around all day being called?
Okay, sweet roll. Yum.
Sometimes I'm I sure you really are as dumb
Never
as you look.
Suspected a thing.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
It sure was good when I ate it a few minutes ago.
What? Dang, I love those sweet rolls old Lady Palmer makes. Just stay out of my way, you got it?
Now go on and enjoy yourself.
Little shit.
What'd Butch want? I thought you were in trouble there for a second.
He wanted my sweet roll, but I told him off.
Wow, you're so tough. You'll have to teach me how to do that sometime. He's not worth worrying about anyway. Most likely to end up a trash burner, right? Thanks for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier. Everything's fine, I hope.
How's it going,
oh,
pal?
Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
I wasn't worried. You can fix anything, right? Anyway,
you guys
I'm
are
glad
dumb.
You can make
Somebody's
it.
Somebody's gotta have a better idea.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Fucking hell, I don't know if he's eating that sweet roll or making out of it. It's really cool. Did you fix it up for me?
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Thanks, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Nose. Baseball cap. We've got a kid's party out, which is whatever. And the melee weapon damage. Sure, that'll come in handy on the way out.
Oh, man, this is a great...
Oh, a balloon.
Grease weasels.
I help with the decorations, you know.
Grease weasels.
Oh, really?
Pretty good.
Wow, the pit boy really makes...
What's that? Okay, party time over.
Oh, hey, it's Jonas. Happy birthday.
Listen, would you put your dad on?
Did everything right? Snakes are cool, right? The bald snakes. What do you guys think?
Enjoying
having a good time. It wasn't easy keeping this a secret.
Now go,
Jonas.
Children cannot sit on stools? What the fuck?
Thanks. I'll send them right down. Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom.
I know.
I've been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Sure thing, Officer Gomez. Well, it's been nice chatting with you.
Happy birthday.
God.
Dearie, my goodness. I hope I didn't miss the party.
I'm not a girl, and I'm not five. Stop calling me dearie.
Of course you're not five. You're a big 10-year-old man now, aren't you? With your very own Pip-Boy. And do you know what I did? Just for the occasion, wrote you a poem. I hope you like it.
Oh, God. Thanks, I guess. Did you get me anything else?
Don't be silly. One poem per birthday, that's my rule. If I gave you two, think how jealous Butch would be.
Thanks again for coming.
Great walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation. Little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mummy, daddy, am I dead? Nay, nay, reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges, strong and male. Father to me, father to all. Overseeing all our lives. Overseeing our lives, our eternities. Oh my god, you know what? Fuck this. Not about that shit.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
I'm not a kid, I'm 10 years old.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise?
What kind of surprise?
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
What do I get to kill?
Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me. Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunt.
Smile.
I was kind of hoping to pose with the gun, but whatever. I'm glad I've spent those last 6 years crouched down.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
anything I need to know about the goat?
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
What the fuck? Do we have to die in the vault? Can't we ever leave?
That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either.
Is it true, Dad? Was everyone born in the vault?
That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here.
Can we talk about Mum?
Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen, there's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate about life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner.
If you say so, Dad.
Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine.
Bye, Dad.
Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
All right, first things first, medicine bobblehead. You found a Vault-Tec limited edition bobblehead. The inscription on the base reads, "The smart man knows a bandage only hides his wounds. Your medicine skill is permanently increased by 10. Look at that, nice and easy straight away.
Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right?
What's that about a real tunnel snake? What toolbox? Conductor. I guess I can take a few things.
I'm a little worried. I hope
you show it to her, Butch. You think you're special because your daddy is the Overseer? She's nothing, Butch.
Go away, you stupid tunnel snake.
Tunnel snakes rule.
Yeah, I got that. Why are you picking on a matter?
None of your business. Because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule!
Hold on. You're in the tunnel snakes? You guys really do rule?
You got that right. Better not forget it either.
Do we have something better to do?
Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule.
It's all this about tunnel snakes.
That's us, and we rule. No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally. You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me.
Later, Paul.
Much later. tunnel snakes rule.